Hi, fifth graders. Today we're going to be looking at function tables, which are also known as input-output tables. It shows a pattern that follows the rule. So for this problem, we're going to find the rule. So right here, I'm going to point to it. This is our input-output table. Input is what you put in, the output is what you get out. And the rule is what you're doing to the input to get the output. All right, so right here we have four options. We have plus 4, subtract 5, multiply 5, or multiply by 6. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go through and start with A. If I add 4 to the input, do I get my output? Well, 1 plus 4 equals 5, so yes. And that's where they try to trick you, is if you get it for the first one, you think you can stop. But you have to make sure that the rule works for all inputs. Okay, so we do 2 plus 4. 2 plus 4 equals 6. That does not equal 10, so that is not the correct rule. So I'm going to go back on all that. So this one is not correct. Now we're going to take away 5. 1 take away 5 is negative 4. That's not even close to 5, so that one is not correct either. So we'll cross that out. Let's multiply by 5 now. 1 times 5 equals 5. That checks out. 2 times 5, does that equal 10? Yep, that checks out, but we don't stop there. 3 times 5, that equals 15. And then 4 times 5 equals 20. So it's a lot of trial and error. So trial and error means try it and then see if you come up with an error. So the correct answer is times 5. I don't need to do times 6 because I already got all the correct answers for here. So let's go on to another one. So here we have our input-output table. Remember, input is what we put in, output is what comes out. And here we have the rule already. So we're adding 14. So we know our output here, and if the rule is to add 14, how could we figure out what our input was? I'm gonna write that all here too. So all of these are adding 14 to get our output. Well, I know that whatever number I have here has to be a number plus 14 equals 15. And I know that's 1. So my input is 1. Here, I have 8 plus 14, so I'll just add those together. I get 22. Here, this is already done. And then this one right here. What number plus 14 equals 39? Well, I know it's not going to be a number bigger than 39 because I don't want to be greater than 39. So I can do some trial and error. That means trying a number until we get it. So I'm going to start with 10. 10 plus 14 equals 24. That's not 39, so I'm going to jump up to 15. 15 plus 14 equals 29. That's not big enough. Do 20 plus 14. Equals 34. We're getting closer to 39. I'm going to do 23 plus 14. That equals 37. We're not there yet. 24 plus 14, 38. And then 25 plus 14, which equals 39. That's correct. So our input was 25. We added 14, and then we got 39. All right. Here we don't have a rule and we don't have our table filled out. So how we figure that out is we look for columns or rows that have both the input and the output. Okay, so we have to figure out what we can do with both of these. It has to be the same. So 56 and 6. How can I relate those two? And 32 and 82. Well, we're getting bigger, right? Which means I would not be dividing or subtracting. So the only two options I have are multiplication and addition. Does any number multiply 6 to 56? So let's think. 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, 42, 48, 54, 60. So I don't have a number that gets to 56 multiplied by 6, so I know it's not that, which means it's addition. So we have to look at 6 plus what number equals 56, and 32 plus what number equals 82. Well, I can figure that out by doing the opposite thing to find my answer here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to rewrite this equation as 56 minus 6 equals my blank. And this will be 82 minus 32, and that will equal my missing piece. So then 56 minus 6 equals 50. 82 minus 32 also equals 50. So when I have an input of 6, I am adding 50, which is my rule, to get my output of 56. So my rule would be add 50, because that's what we did here. We added 50, and we added 50. So for this one, if we add 50, we'll get 59. Add 50, we have to do the opposite here because we have my output. So 66 minus 50 equals 16, and we have all our missing pieces. All right, complete the table and find the rule. All right, so here we have two columns that have both an input and the output. We have to find the rule. So the input is smaller than the output, so we know we are not doing division or subtraction. It's not an option. So that means we have addition or multiplication. All right, so I know that 1 times 10 equals 10, right? The only thing that I can multiply 1 by is 10 to get 10. Let's see if that works here. If I multiply this by 10, can I multiply this by 10? 4 times 10 equals 40. Yep. So my rule is multiplying by 10. So 2 times 10 equals 20. 3 times 10, well, that was me getting ahead of myself. If we have all of this times 10, if 30, what number times 10 equals 30? That's 3. 3 times 10 is 30. 5 times 10 is 50. Very good. So our rule is multiplying by 10. Here we have to complete the table and then find the rule. So here we only have one to look at, 3 and 15. Okay? 3 and 15. So I could do, since I have a smaller input than my output, my only two options are addition or multiplication. Okay? So here we have a number plus, so here we have 3 to 15. So let's just start with addition. What number plus 3 equals 15? That's 12. So then plus 12, plus 12, plus 12, plus 12. 5, 12. So what number plus 12 equals 5? That's going to be a negative number. So plus 12 doesn't work, which means we're going to have to do multiplication. Okay, so let's see. How many times does 3 15? So let's do 3, 6, 9, 12, 15. That's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 15. So we do 5, so times 5. So my rule is times 5. Well, let's check before we say that completely. Do we have a number times 5 that equals 20? So let's keep counting. Let's start counting by 5s. 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35. I'm going to stop there. So what number times 5 equals 5? Well, one group of 5, so we have 1. 2 times 5 is 1, 2, 10. I'm counting like this, 1, 2. 3 times 5 is 15. What number times 5 is 20? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then what's 5 times 5? 25. So our rule is multiply by 5.